what may have already been a trend in some way then becomes, you know, more popularized, I think.
That about wraps it up for this edition of House of Style. Coming up in April, we'll have our annual swimsuit issue, but don't get the sunblock out just yet. See you soon. Bye.
You're tuned into MTV's new show's Showcase. Stay tuned for Buzz Cut with host Karen Bryant next on MTV.
Rest assured this will not last. Take a turn for the worst. Your hate clipped and distant. Your love to the cow.
MTV's House of Style is brought to you by Finesse. Sometimes you need a little finesse, sometimes you need a lot.
It's an unforgettable look. It's an inventive sound. It's the coolest of the hot and the hottest of the cool. It's from the best known, the less known, and the unknown. It's the buzz, the most talked about moments in music today. Welcome to Buzz Cut. If you've seen the MTV spot where the meaty voice dares you to find out what the buzz is about, and you've been waiting patiently, well, you should grab a bucket of popcorn and kickstart your VCR, because this is a show bold enough to explore the buzz. The Buzz Cut's going to give you a daring mix of videos, never-before-seen live performances, and will spotlight new trends in music from artists hardwired to the buzz. In this month's show, we're going to feature new videos by Metallica and the Red Hot Chili Peppers, two cult bands that have infiltrated the mainstream, plus fresh cuts by artists on the crest of success like Matthew Sweet and the Disposable Heroes of Hip-Hopercy. We're also going to look into moshing, the primal dance of the pit, and we're going to plug into the buzz with live performances by Nirvana and Teenage Fan Club. We're going to kick things off tonight with the latest from a band that's been crunching their own brand of metal for almost a decade. Though their previous albums sold truckloads without the benefit of radio airplay, the release of their recent self-titled album blew the roof off, ripping them out of the underground and catapulting them to mega success. Longtime fans and new converts anxiously await the arrival of each new video. So without further ado, this is Metallica with Nothing Else Matters. Rock and roll and comics and cartoons have always enjoyed a colorful relationship. Bands like Anthrax and White Trash have put them on their album covers, and others like Tom Tom Club and Megadeth have used animation in their videos. We asked the writer of Captain America why comics and cartoons are often used in videos, and this is what he had to say.
They're like MTV, only they're still pictures. Mm-hmm. I think they're very exciting, they're very dynamic, they're in your face, they're short compared to novels or something like that, and they're very colorful, very larger-than-life figures.
Girlfriend, the latest video by Matthew Sweet, plays on our fascination with comic book imagery. You know, when you hear the term alternative music, the first thing that comes to mind might be bands from England or musicians with funny haircuts. Although Matthew Sweet's music is considered alternative. He did grow up in the Midwest, though, and, you know, looks like a normal all-American guy. With three albums full of catchy, bittersweet pop tunes under his belt, Sweet is a hot buzzword in the music industry right now. Here's the title track to his latest album, Girlfriend. We all know rap has come a long way since its birth in the South Bronx street corners. Remember back there when they had the beatboxes like all that, and you know, the big hair, funny clothes, that whole bit. But things have changed a lot, and right now we're going to check out some current artists who are stretching rap's boundaries. Today's rap fringe acts are pushing music beyond definition. The raw street tough rap of the late 70s has evolved into a new scene and a new sound that derives its influences from all around the world. The Dream Warriors are two rappers who emigrated to Toronto from the West Indies and whose music has broken boundaries fusing rap and jazz.
I feel a lot of people are, you know, going on jazz just to get a different audience. It's kind of like to show them that you can, you know, rap can be on anything, you know, even reggae. What I just spoke into a language called speech, you try to catch
it, but you just can't reach. Hip-hop innovators De La Soul continue to kick out the rhymes, but they don't see themselves as being more creative than other rappers when it comes to using new ideas. Exit the old
style into the new, but not what we do and what a rap band might see us do, they be like, wow, you know, this is the next level, let's try it. And like people who we look up to or see in front of us, from rap bands to rock bands to whatever, we try to add those elements to make us reflect. But the songs created in their shacks be so wick, wick, whack.
In a similar vein, PM Dawn are a new act that take their harmonies to the next level. They call their style mellow and blissed out, and they don't consider themselves a part of the rap scene.
You can look at the way a rap song is written, a real rap song, and look at one of mine, and you're just like, where's the connection?
Perhaps the most innovative rap act out now is Tribe Called Quest. Using everything from obscure old songs to sampled sitar, they see a wide open future for rap.
It's not as minimal as it was 10 years ago. It's becoming more innovative and creative and all that stuff, so it's only going to get better.
Our next video comes from a rap group unique in several aspects. Unlike most rappers, Arrested Development does not come from an urban area. They're also one of the few rap acts composed of both men and women. The title of their debut album refers to the amount of time that passed between the formation of the group and the signing of their recording agreement with Chrysalis. Speech, the group's writer and producer, calls Arrested Development's unique blend of sounds life music. Their first single and video, Tennessee, is set in the decaying countryside where Speech spent his childhood summers, and you should look for the banner in this one. Tennessee. 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 Lord, I've really been real. Tennessee. Woo! Yeah. Tennessee. To Tennessee. After the break, we'll go under the bridge with the Red Hot Chili Peppers, and we'll mosh with Nirvana, so don't move.
It's always a good sign when a band that are true to themselves and to their art, like Nirvana, you know, can completely rise above and come out of nowhere and just sail to the top like that. I mean, that's like a good little stab of hope for all the other grovelers out there who want to do what they do and not change it to fit any sort of preconceived formula.
MTV presents U2's first tour of the decade. From the moment they hit the stage, we'll keep you posted with exclusive news, tour dates, and road reports. MTV, your source for exclusive U2 tour information. Keep watching.
The great American legal system.
We'll be in book for murder.
Is about to meet its match.
We got an attorney in the family. Great, who?
We stick out like a sore thumb around here.
Oh, yeah, you blend.
The two Utes.
Did you say Utes?
Yeah, two Utes.
Hey, little Yankee, what's?
My Cousin Vinny.
How long have you been practicing?
Almost 6 weeks.
Whoa!
Rated R. Sneak preview Saturday night in select cities.
Let's take my limo.
No, let's take my limo.
Hey, let's take my limo.
Keep this phrase handy. For the AT&T It Can Happen to Me sweepstakes. Hip trip number 3 will fly you and your coolest friend to 3 3-day concert weekends anywhere in the continental U.S. Just bring the appropriate attitude.
Of course I have a backstage pass.
See issues of these magazines for sweepstakes entry form. Hey, with AT&T, it's easy to be well connected. Only for you, only from us.
Do. Love the taste?
I do.
I do.
Cinnamon, fresh mint.
I do.
I do.
I do. I do.
sugar-free Trident. The one gum more dentists recommend actually tastes great, too.
Who wants Trident?
I do.
Who?
She does.
Who wants Trident?
We do.
I do.
Good for your teeth, great taste, too.
Who wants Trident?
I do.
Yo, come on, move this. Shake that body. Shake that body. Baby, let me show you how to do this. You got it. Move this. You got it. Move that. Shake that body for me.
Revlon Guaranteed Nail Enamel. 85 colors guaranteed to be the best you've ever worn.
Experience the smooth sound of a live concert right from your automobile with the latest in digital and high-quality amplified systems professionally installed at Crystal Sonics of Glendale, like the Pioneer Premier KEX M900 Multiplay CD Control Auto-Reverse Cassette with Detachable Face Security. For the do-it-yourselfers, you'll find it all. Custom kits, parts, and accessories. Crystal Sonics of Glendale, 1638 South Central Avenue, one block south of San Fernando Road in Glendale.
Power 106, LA's hottest music.
LA's hottest music.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and when me. Let's talk about
LA's hottest music. Power 106.
Flea, the legendary bassist of the Red Hot Chili Peppers, appeared in Gus Van Sant's latest movie, My Own Private Idaho. Van Sant also hooked up with Flea and the rest of the Chili Peppers to direct their latest video, Under the Bridge. Now, if you've seen Funky Monks, the band's home video, you might already be clued into the meaning behind the song. Now, according to singer Anthony Kiedis, it's about a place in downtown L.A. where he used to hang out during a low point in his life. The lyrics came to him while he was driving on an L.A. freeway one day, and it really is a tremendous song, so let's take a look at the video. Dinner. We'll put together some primal chords, a few stage divers, and a bunch of sweaty, swirling bodies in a concert hall with poor ventilation, and you've got moshing, the postmodern lovin'. For more info on the subject, we asked the experts.
I gotta know about this pit slamming stuff. I might get hurt, and they look so angry and upset about society.
Pit things gotta happen, man. That's the dance.
It started out, you know, the Black Flag was big on the West Coast and bands like that, and skanking, you know, ska and reggae stuff like that was popular, and the movement of ska, you know, the movement yeah, bumping into it, yeah, and Black Flag with the knocking people over and ramming their heads into the wall, it combined, and just formed moshing, you know.
It is like a wonderful, you know, cosmic cesspool of physical delight traveling around in that pit. It's like an hour and a half out of someone's life where they can come and totally get all of their pent-up anxiety out in a good way, you know, by connecting to the music and the energy, and it's looks nice.
I've seen someone jump off the stage, bam, crash on the head, get up all bloody, stand up, gets up, walks away, yeah!
We've played in places that had seats. People beat the shit out of each other to try to say whose seat it is. I say whoever wants the space, go ahead and take it. That's what a pit is.
Yeah, every man for himself.
But you gotta help your friends out. Right, you gotta help them out, man. You don't wanna leave them hanging there, because you might be the next guy up.
If someone goes up, keep them up. If they fall down, you pick them up as soon as you can.
It's all friendly. It's just excitement, and it's just intense, but it's not meant to hurt anybody.
As long as you do it with a positive vibe, you know, that's all you need, and nobody will get hurt.
Up next, we've got a live performance from a band that's no stranger to moshing. Nirvana began its performance.
This will not last. Take a turn for the worst. Keep your hate to ten distant. Keep your love to another cow.
It's The Buzz, the most talked about moments in music today. Welcome to Buzz Cut. If you've seen the MTV spot where the meaty voice dares you to find out what The Buzz is about, and you've been waiting patiently, well, you should grab a bucket of popcorn and kickstart your VCR, because this is a show bold enough to explore The Buzz. The Buzz Cut's going to give you a daring mix of videos, never-before-seen live performances, and will spotlight new trends in music from artists hardwired to The Buzz. In this month's show, we're going to feature new videos by Metallica and the Red Hot Chili Peppers, two cult bands that have infiltrated the mainstream, plus fresh cuts by artists on the crest of success like Matthew Sweet and the Disposable Heroes of Hip-Hopercy. We're also going to look into moshing, the primal...
MTV's House of Style is brought to you by Finesse. Sometimes you need a little finesse, sometimes you need a lot.
It's an unforgettable look. It's an inventive sound. It's the coolest of the hot and the hottest of the cool. It's from the best known, the less known, and the unknown. Dance of the Pit, and we're going to plug into The Buzz with live performances by Nirvana and Teenage Fan Club. We're going to kick things off tonight with the latest from a band that's been crunching their own brand of metal for almost a decade. Though their previous album sold truckloads without the benefit of radio airplay, the release of their recent self-titled album blew the roof off, ripping them out of the underground and catapulting them to mega success. Longtime fans and new converts anxiously await the arrival of each new video. So without further ado, this is Metallica with Nothing Else Matters.
What may have already been a trend in some way then becomes, you know, more popularized, I think.
That about wraps it up for this edition of House of Style. Coming up in April, we'll have our annual swimsuit issue, but don't get the sunblock out just yet. See you soon. Bye.
Tune into MTV's new show's Showcase. Stay tuned for Buzz Cut with host Karen Bryant next on MTV.